Now we can take the expression for force. Force, when it is placed in, when charges are placed in medium, we can write with F medium is equal to 1 by k, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, q1 q2 by r square. So this is the expression for force when charges are placed in medium. So based on this, we can create four different situations. That means like that, based on those four situations, they have been asking questions in the examination. Okay, so what are those four situations? Mathematically, we can simply write those expressions without going very, there will be no need to remember the formula. We can write from this. Now, force, dielectric constant, charges, distance between the charges. These are the four variables in the equation. Epsilon naught is the constant value, 8.85 into 10 to the minus 12 value. That is constant value. Now, these are the four variables. If you want to relate any two variables, we should keep other two variables as constant. It's a mathematical technique, that's all. Okay, four variables are there. If you want to relate any two variables, we should keep another two variables must be constant. So based on those, we can get these points. Okay, so in the first case, these are very important four cases we can get from this relation. Okay, so first one, we can keep charges and distance as the same. That means q1 q2 same, r is also same. We can change this one and this one. That means medium is changing, how the forces changes. Now in the words, how they can create the situation is two same charges, are placed at same separation in different media. Medium is different, charges are same, distance is also same. So two same charges are placed at same separation in different media. That means these two are constant. Then we can write F is proportional to 1 by k. Now we can write F is proportional to 1 by k. That implies F into k is equal to constant. Therefore, F1 k1 is equal to F2 k2. This is one relation we can get from this one. Then how they will ask the question based on this parameter? We can see two charges, q1 and q2, are placed at distance r. This distance of r in a vacuum. The force between the charges is F. Now, these same charges are placed in medium of dielectric constant k is equal to 2. Now, same charges placed at the same separation, but in different media or dielectric medium of dielectric constant k is equal to 2. Then what is the value of force? So, F1 is equal to F, K1 is equal to 1. For air medium or vacuum medium, K1 is equal to 1. So, K is equal to 2, K2 is equal to 2. Then what is the value of F2? Now, F1 is F, K1 is 1, F2 is, we should calculate, K2 is 2. Now, F2 is equal to F by 2. So this is how they make the question based on this relation. Two charges, two same charges are placed at some separation, the force between them is something. Now the same charges are placed in medium of the electric constant K something at same separation, then they can ask any one of the value, either forces or dielectric constant values, any one of the values they can ask from this relation. This is how they will create the situation to based on this relation. Okay, this is the first relation. Okay, in first relation what we have taken, Q1 Q2 are same, R is also same, but we are placed in different media. What is forces? Now coming to second point, we can keep first we keep these two as constant. Okay, now Q1 Q2 K, these two are keeping as constant. Q1 Q2 same, Q1 Q2 same, and K is also same. What is meant by K? Dielectric constant. That means medium is also same. That means two same charges placed in same medium, but at different distances. Two same charges placed in same medium, but at different distances. Now, as Q and Q1, Q2 are same, we can write F into R square. That means F is proportional to 1 by R square. Now, you can write F is proportional to 1 by R square. That implies FR square is equal to constant. Therefore, F1 R1 square is equal to F2 R2 square. Based on this formula, they ask a previous neat question. Like as usual, different distances they will go and we should calculate any one of the value. R1 or R2 or F1 or F2, any one of the value they will ask. Third one, K is the same, R is the same. So different charges placed at same separation in same medium. Now we can write F is proportional to Q1, Q2. So we can write F by F dash is equal to Q1, Q2 by Q1, Q2 dash. Next, what are the charges we can write? Okay, depends. Next, fourth one. This is a very important case. This is also previous question. There is a previous question on this condition. Based on this condition and based on the fourth condition, they asked the question in previous examination. In old AAPMT, that means old, not old, almost 2009, 2010, like that, they ask the question on this relation also. Okay, so most of the time they will ask the questions on this. Okay, fourth one. What is fourth one? We can take F is the same, charges are also same. F is the same, charges also same. So from this equation we can write condition for experiences same force by same charges placed in different media at different distances. So condition for experiences, same force by same charged particles in different media at different distances. Now we can write kr square is equal to constant. Okay, see the equation. F is the same, q1, q2 is same. So k into r square is constant. That means k1 r1 square is equal to k2 r2 square. So what is the question they asked in previous examination, previous NEET examination based on this one is, same charges are placed at a distance r0 in vacuum. Now, they are placed in medium of dielectric constant K. You see this relation. First, where they placed? Vacuum. Vacuum dielectric constant is 1. What is the separation vacuum? R0. That means 1 into R0 square is equal to second time where they placed medium of dielectric constant K. K into what is R? R2 square. So R0 means we can simply take it as R. Therefore, R square is equal to R0 square by K. Therefore, R is equal to R0 by root K. Okay, in the options they given, A option A, R0 into root K. Option B, R0 by root K. Option C, R0 K. Option D, R0 by K. Pardon by K. So you need to go with this option, R0 by root. Okay, right. Next, some other model of numericals also they will ask based on this Coulomb's law. So the basic model is F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square. Charges are double, distance is half, or charges are half, distance is double, what is the force and all, that is basic question. So this is half, 1/2 or double, like that they will ask the question. That is the basic the question they may ask from this formula. Okay, and second one is we can take two charges, they will give two charges. Q1 is equal to some 5 microcoulomb, Q2 is equal to some minus 2 microcoulomb. Now the force between them is F. These are separated by distance r. Now some external charge q is equal to 10 microcoulomb is added, 10 microcoulomb is added to both the q1 and also q2. then force is F dash. Then what is the value of F dash? What is the value of F dash? So in the given options, you see, this is 5 microcoulomb. This is minus 2 microcoulomb. So positive charge, negative charge, unlike charges. What type of force it is? Attractive force. Unlike charges, attractive force. Now 10 microcoulomb is added to this one. As we know, additivity of electric charges. So we can add Q1 plus Q2 or Q1 minus Q2. Algebraically, we can add these charges according to the property of additivity of electric charges. Now 10 plus 5, 15. That means Q1 dash is equal to 15 microcoulomb. Now Q2 dash is equal to how much? 10 plus of minus 2. That means 8 microcoulomb. This is plus 15. This is plus 8. Then what type of force it is? Repulsive force. So in the given options, they will give magnitude along with the within the bracket they will give attractive, repulsive, attractive, repulsive, like that they will. Now in this case we can get a net charge, and based on that we can calculate whether the force is attractive or repulsive based on the nature of the charges. So adding some external charge to the individual charges and asking for this is another model of question they may ask from this Coulomb's law. Okay, right. So these are all the model of numericals you should practice. I will send the file, and tomorrow we'll discuss numericals on this. So while solving numerical, these all the models will come. So there we can apply this situation to calculate those numericals. Okay, and next model is, they will give one charge Q. Some charge Q, and this is another charge minus Q. Now some percent of this charge is transferred to the next charge. You know, according to conservation of energy, conservation of charge, charge can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be transferred from one body to the another body. So in NEET 2019, this question was asked based on this transfer of charge. So what is the question they asked is, in the previous old AAPMT also, they asked the same model of question, but with a different percentage. Now, this is Q and this is minus Q. The force is F. Force is F. Distance is R. Now, in the second case, this is Q dash. This is minus Q. For example, this is, we can take this as Q1 dash. This is Q2 dash. Now 25% of first charge is transferred to the next charge. 25% of first charge is transferred to the next charge. Then what happened? You see, then force is some F dash. Then what is the value of F dash? Distance is same. Now you see, Q1 dash is equal to Q minus 25% of Q. 25% of charge is lost in first charge. But in case of Q2 charge, what happened? To this charge, 25% of charge is added. What is the loss in the first charge is transferred to the next charge, which means the charge should be added to the next, because charge can neither be created nor destroyed. It can be transferred from one charge to the one body to the another body. Here, 25% is lost. The 25% has added to this one. Now what happened? This is Q minus 25 by 100 into Q. This will be 100 minus 25, 75 by 100 into Q. This will be 3 by 4 into Q. 3 by 4 into Q. Now in the same way, Q2 dash is equal to minus Q plus 25 by 100 into Q. So minus 100 plus 25. This is minus 75 by 100 into Q. This is minus 3 by 4 into Q. Okay. Now F is equal to K into Q square by R square. That is equation number 1. Now F dash is equal to K into 3Q by 4 into 3Q by 4. We can take only magnitudes. Later we can, if they ask me about whether they attract or repulse means we can say attraction, and this is also attraction by r square. Now this one 3 into 3 9, 4 into 4 16 into k q square by r square. What is this k q square by r square? Is nothing but f. So f dash is equal to 9 f by 16. So this is NEET 2019 question. This is two times they asked in previous and recent, I mean 2009-10 like that to 2019. Then two times they asked the same question, but percentage is different. 25% the question they asked in 2019. Okay. That is one more. Next step. Based on the process of conduction, if this is a sphere, a carrying charge Q of radius R, this is of another sphere. This is of, for example, Q. This is, for example, this is also Q, for example. So this is sphere A and this is sphere B. These two are separated by distance D from center to center. This is D. Now force between them is F is equal to K into Q square by D square. Okay, right. Now, this is positively charged plus Q, and this is also positively charged plus Q, positively, negatively, whatever you can give. Now we are taking uncharged sphere of same size as that of this, as that of A and B. These are also same. Okay. Now this is C. Now this sphere C is first in contact with the sphere A. Then what happened when these two are in contact with each other? Then what happened by the process of conduction? Redistribution of charges will happen, as because of both charges are same, both sizes of size of the spheres is same, then this charges will give q by 2, the charge will becomes q by 2. Now this sphere is removed. Then what is the force between A and B? Now what happened? A charge became q by 2, P charge became q. Then force will be different. Now otherwise, and after that, this q by 2 is again in touch with point B, that is sphere B. Now C is in contact with the sphere B. Now this is q by 2, this is q. Now what is total charge? Q plus 2, q by 2. That means 1 plus 1 by 2, 3 q by 2. Now this 3q by 2 will be equally distributed on these two spheres. That means on this charge is 3q by 4, on this charge is 3q by 4, half of 3q by 2, this is 3q by 4. Now if charge is removed, now finally A sphere getting a charge of q by 2, B sphere getting a charge of 3q by 4. Now what happened? Force will become, this is A, this is B. Why? Because charges are became like this. First uncharged sphere is in contact with sphere A, removed, and then contact with B. Then because of that, charges are redistributed like this. Now F dash is equal to K into Q by 2 into 3Q by 4 by D square. Now 1 by 2, 3 by 4. So this is equal to 3 by 8 into F. This is also a previous question. Force will becomes 3F by 8. This is how, based on the conduction process, they will ask the question related to force. Okay. So basic model, these are the four cases directly they will ask the questions on this. Directly to medium, when it is placed in medium, F vacuum by K, medium related questions. And these two, four cases questions. And then these are the different model of questions. Well, charges are half double, distance is double half, like the basic questions they ask. After that, percentage of charges, adding of charges and force, percentage of transfer of charge, and because of conduction, because of the conduction. Okay, right. Next step. And another model. For example, if the charge is placed here, Q1 charge is placed here. Now, Q2 charge is placed at a distance r. Now this Q2 charge is revolving around this charge Q1. So, if any body is revolving around any other body, which means this is under centripetal force. The centripetal force required to revolve this charge about this charge is provided by the electrostatic force between these two charges. That means, so here electrostatic force will be equal to centripetal force. Now, what is electrostatic force? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square is equal to m v square by r. So this is another important application of Coulomb's law. When force between the two charges, when one of the charges revolving around this one, and if these two are having equal charge, now we can write, so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, this is q square by r square is equal to mv squared by r. Like this, we can write if they are equal charges. And according to quantization condition, q is equal to n e. So in the place of q, we can write n square e square. So one time they asked the question on what are the number of charge carriers are revolving, number of electrons, how many number of electrons are revolving if this much of charge is revolving like this. So n square e square we can represent. So n square value we can represent in this. And also time period. Time period is equal to, so velocity is equal to distance by time. Then time is equal to distance by velocity. Basic relation. Now time is equal to distance velocity. What is distance? Time period is nothing but the time taken by the charge to complete one complete revolution. So now if it is completed one complete revolution, how much distance it can travel is nothing but circumference of the circle. So circumference of the circle is nothing but 2 pi r by velocity v. Now from this relation we can find the value of velocity. That velocity value we can substitute here, then we can get the expression for time period. So this time period related question one time they asked in the examination, and also number of charge carrier related question also they asked in previous examination. Okay, relation based questions. Okay, this is understanding of this situation is electrostatic force between the charges is equal to centripetal force. That is the relation we should understand from this explanation. Okay, so these are the different model of questions they will ask from the concept of Coulomb's law. And also this one they will give one sphere. And if it is given some positive charge, now to this sphere we are connected another, from the same point of suspension another sphere is taken, conducting sphere, it is also given some positive charge, so because of this like charges, what happen? These two are repelled, that means this is separation between the charges, spheres R. This is repulsive force. This is in this direction and this is in this direction. Now we can get, based on the force, we can take the situation. Just you can take, like, this is the initial position. This is aside with some angle theta, which means this is the force F. Okay, so this is a distance. Now this is tension in the string. Now tension can be resolved into components. If this is theta, this is theta, then this will be t cos theta. This is mg. This is t sin theta. Resolution of the vectors. Resolution of the vector. Now, what is force? Coulomb force. F is equal to t sin theta. That is equation number one. So, mg is equal to t cos theta. This is equation number two. So, 1 by 2 will give sin by cos. Tt will cancel. That means tan theta is equal to f by mg. So, this is very important relation from this explanation. This is another model of questions. They will ask based on this situation. So, they will give, hanging two spheres, and they are giving same charges to this both the spheres. Then, because of electrostatic pull, they will get repulsed with each other. In the case of repulsion force, this force will balance according to resolution of the vectors. Based on this relation, F is equal to F, tan is equal to F by mg. Sometimes they will ask force, sometimes they will ask what is the mass of the sphere, like that questions, they will ask on this. Okay. So these are the different model of questions they may ask from the concept of Coulomb's law. Okay. So now, based on all these concepts, we should practice the numericals related to Coulomb's law. And then we can go for force between multiple charges, that is principle of superposition. Okay. So today I will send the questions related to Coulomb's law. So first, you remember one thing. If you practice the questions on the day itself, means then you can get clarity. Now you understood the concept and how they will ask the questions from this concept. So based on this concept, you practice the numericals simultaneously, then automatically you will get full clarity about the concept. Then you won't forget. If you leave this concept here itself and you are not practice any numericals, means again while solving the numericals you will get doubt. Okay. So my suggestion is you practice the numericals on that day itself to get more clarity on the concepts. Okay. So this is about Coulomb's law. Okay, so tomorrow we'll discuss some numericals, and then we can go for next concept, force between multiple charges. There also a very important model of numericals are there. We will discuss that. We'll try to complete numerical related to Coulomb's law and force between multiple charges related concept along with numericals we'll complete by tomorrow. Okay.